What if I tell you that this slightly modified power bank has a hidden flash storage, and only what you need to activate it, a slightly modified RFID key? Hello, this is Barely Painted, and today I show you how to hide USB flash storage inside the power bank. Firstly, we should remove memory module from the metal case to disassemble this USB flash memory stick. All I need is modified hairpin. I should mention that metal case is very slippery. This is why I use a screwdriver, simply to pull the module more easily. There are a lot of different models of USB flash memory sticks, and all of them built differently. This is mean that disassembly process will be significantly different from what I show you in this video. Here a closer look to the insert, which holds USB flash memory module inside the case. USB flash module by itself measures about 25 by 11 mm. Before disassembling the power bank, I completely discharge it. At first, I decided that discharging the power bank using another power bank is a great idea, but then I realized that it would be better and faster to use a phone, which also allows me to check how it works. There are two decorative panels held by some sort of adhesive and pins. To loosen the adhesive, I slightly heat up the bottom panel using a gas torch. Remember that battery cells should not be heated more than 60 degrees Celsius. Now comes the tricky part – prying panel without damaging it. My power bank has a broken corner, which can be used to pry it more easily, but I still use an X-Acto knife. Under the decorative panel we can see a protective insert, which held it by four Phillips screws. They screwed directly to the main shell and additionally fixed by thread lock. Modern power banks have glued pouch cells to the case, which makes disassembly process very difficult, if not impossible, without permanent damage. Part of the insert acts like a spacer between metal shell and battery cells. This is why I use a screwdriver to remove it from the case. Top panel also fixed by adhesive and pins. Because much less of surface held by adhesive and all electronics located there, I decided to remove it without heat. To insert guitar pick, I use a flathead screwdriver, which can be placed under USB Type-A port opening. As you can see, this can be done only with one hand. Here we can see adhesive and three pins, one of which I broke. There are also four screws, which should be removed. At this point, the whole battery assembly can be removed from the shell. I gently pushed from the bottom and the whole assembly easily came out. Two more screws should be removed, which holds the main board. There is only one place where the USB flash memory module can be mounted. As you can see, there is no space under the plastic frame. Because of that, I will put a switch between the battery cells. This is not the most convenient place, because screw channels go through the whole metal body. As you can see, there is almost no clearance between cells and metal case. This is magnetic SPDT switch. SPDT read switch always stays on, but direction of power flow changes based on resilient magnetic element position. Here you can see how this switch is working. When I bring the magnet closer to the switch, it changes power flow direction. Firstly, I solder wires to the switch legs. Not bad as for me. I also use heat shrink tubes to prevent switch legs from short circuit. To switch between USB flash and charging modes, I break positive output on the board by completely desoldering one leg from the board. It is also possible to completely remove the leg from the port and solder it out of the main board. As you can see, I already melted the protective sleeve of the middle cell. Almost all USB flash memory modules have soldering points for LED, even if they are not equipped with an LED from the factory. I decided to use this opportunity and solder a tiny SMD LED. Soldering wires to the flash module is difficult because it's easy to damage flash module by overheating it. And it's much easier with this soldering iron, which can reach up to 500 degrees Celsius. I take a break for about 1 minute to let the flash module cool down after each wire has been soldered. Here you can see the final result, when all soldering work is done. Time to fasten switch to the cells. For this I use Kapton tape. For USB flash module insulation I use heat shrink tube. SMD LED will be held by double side tape. It is also possible to use Kapton or electrical tape, but the heat shrink tubes have a cleaner look. And here the whole unit assembled. I use more Kapton tape to fasten the USB flash module and wires. Here you can see how I mounted the switch. It is more difficult to put metal shell back, this is why I put it out of camera. I decided to apply decorative covers without adhesive. As you can see, it holds firmly. At this point, I should say that data wires for power delivery also important. And when I sold the USB flash module directly to them, the power bank stuck in the charging loop. After this, I completely desoldered USB port legs from the board. And now you can see the result. Power bank still works properly, and it finally shuts down when the load is not present. But the maximum amount of power is limited by phone, because the actual charging circuit is located inside the phone, not the power bank. To make it work again properly with the phone, simply bridge data pins on the charging cable. This puts your phone in general charging mode. Some models of phones could require different soldering combinations and use of resistors. Let's check the main purpose of this video. Does the USB flash module actually work? To connect it to the phone, we need USB OTG adapter, USB Type-C female to Type-A male adapter, USB Type-C to Type-A cable, phone itself, and of course, power bank. You can see the whole assembly in frame, no hidden wires. If all is done right, when I put magnet nearly to the switch, phone should recognize USB flash storage and show it in file manager. And yes, it works. Now let's test it by copying something from the phone to the flash module. This is not the fastest flash memory, but it's copying files actually faster than I expected. You probably can't see LED because it's quite dim, even without lighting. I switched all lights and boosted video to show you that LED is actually functional. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you later.